Good afternoon. The first item of business is time for reflection, and our time for reflection leader today is Dr. Musharraf Hussain, OBE.
Thank you. Presiding Officer, the members of Scottish Parliament, good afternoon and assalamu alaikum. May peace be with you all. I'm delighted to be present in this wonderful Scottish Parliament. Scotland is a nation of great men and women, from William Wallace to Andy Murray, Sir Alex Ferguson to Remy McIntosh, and of course, Robert Burns, the man of words, the Scots poet. Words have power. Words are read. Reading is a great way of leading an intelligent life that supports democracy, promotes respect of human rights. We read books for pleasure, pastime, and sometimes to become smart. We read religious books for getting instructions that will help us live a good life, to experience the closeness, the proximity, and the love of God. As legislators, you make laws. You know why it's important. It's the basis of a just society. Law appeals to reason. It makes sense. The Quran, the holy book of Islam, is a book of law. But more importantly, it teaches moral values, rules that determine the way you think. It creates a state of mind that leads to good actions, an attitude to be kind so that we can practice the moral values of kindness, patience, and forgiveness. The Quran, like the Gospels, is full of such moral teachings. The Muslim families, like majority of Scottish people, are deeply concerned about preserving and transmitting the traditional moral values, because we want kind and caring citizens in the future. Moral values are fundamental for flourishing and healthy human society. The Quran uses various styles of teaching morality, didactic instructions, and storytelling. It promotes these values by telling stories of great masters, Abraham, Moses, Jesus, and Muhammad. What does the Quran offer, this holy book of Islam? Life in our self-smartphone society is challenging. It's fast-moving, and social media influences our mood and lives, creating fear and insecurity, unrealistic sense of independence. Yet, the interdependency is the reality. And I want to just stress that. Yet, the interdependency is the reality. This is what moral and spiritual values of the Quran describe page after page: cooperation, working together. Psychologists are saying that people are suffering from moral confusion today. Many people are lost to hopelessness. Others lack sense of meaning and purpose of life. They have trouble distinguishing right from wrong. They question whether such standards even exist. The Quran is a manual, a guide for our worldly lives. Every Friday afternoon, before the congregational prayer, I read this verse from the pulpit, just like the imams here in Scotland read every Friday. Inna Allah ya'muru bil adl wal ihsan wa ita'i dhil qurba wa yanha 'anil fakhsha'i wal munkar, which means God commands justice, generosity, and of giving and taking care of your relatives. He forbids indecency, all kinds of evil and cruelty. He teaches you this so you will live a good life. As a translator of the Quran in plain English, I have presented all of you with a copy, a complimentary copy. Please enjoy reading it and capture its gems, savor its pearls and spices. God bless you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Hussain. Thank you.